up? What's up? What it do? What it do? It's your boy Lou from the Lou. You know, a whole lot of this, a whole lot of that. And the state rampant doing crime in the city. I don't want to keep talking about the dirt, but shit, nigga, we stay doing dirt, so I'm gonna keep talking about the dirt. And when somebody do something great, then I'm gonna talk about something great. Simple and plain. Now, I've been keeping up with this story. Dude got charged for killing his man in front of his baby. He didn't shoot the baby, thank God, but he still shot the daddy in front of the baby. And on Lucas and Hunt. This is last year though. But dude got a $1 million cash bond. His name Eric Carlos. And he got second degree murder for shooting in the car at somebody he had beef with. On top of that, dude had his child in the car. I can understand beef and I know drama and all that. And one thing I was raised on growing up in the streets was you don't do dirt to women and little kids and old folks. Now, it's the women out there that'll shoot you quick as a dude. And these old people crazy. They don't care. They'll shoot you and do all that other shit to you. But you gotta spare them sometimes. You know, old folks and babies don't really know. They mind not really knowing what they doing. So you kind of gotta spare them. But when it comes to some other people, sometimes you can't show mercy because they'll come back and do something to you. I ain't saying killing is right. I ain't saying you should take another life. I'm saying that if somebody tried to kill you, what would you do? You know, if I was in a situation and somebody was shooting at me or tried to stab me or hit me with a car and I got away, the next chance I get when I see this person, I don't know how I will react. I ain't saying I'd kill him, stab him or shoot him or hit him with a car, but I don't know how I will react. And when you live in St. Louis, we not a large city. We not a real big city. So you guaranteed to run into somebody at least 2 times a month. You never know. You know, you can go to, we going to the same hookah bars and hookah lounges. We at the same club, the same gas stations. We turn the same corners. We turn the same streets in St. Louis. So if you got a beef with a cat in St. Anne, and you stay off of, shit, I don't know, Minnesota, you gonna see him somewhere. And if you got beef with him, it's gonna get dealt with right then and there. It could be kids around, grown folks, mamas, dogs, cats, it don't matter. Bullets ain't got no name. But you have to know who you mad at. You have to know who you upset at. Now, this dude that shot this man in front of his baby in the car, he could have shot the baby. He would have got the death sentence right then and there. But they gave him second degree. He'd be out 15, 20 years. He'd be home. Now, with that being said, knowing that he killed somebody, people on the street, and the man baby was in the car, how will the victim family feel about that in the next 15 years when this man come home? Or even if his family's still on the street? What if somebody wanted to retaliate against him and his sister and his little brother? What if they don't show his kids no mercy? So we got to think about that. And we got to start putting morals and values on each other. If you mad at him, whoop his ass. If he try to kill you, that's a different story. It's a different story. I could recall the time, man, when I had beef with a cat back in the day. Me and my crew had beef with some other cats. And the fool pulled up on me with his son in the car. I had a gun on me. You know, I had a gun on me. And it was funk. And I was ready to put some in him and in his car. But I seen his shorty in the back seat. And a nigga pulled up on me like, Lou, I want you to take a ride with me. Is you crazy? I said, you got your son in the back seat. He saved your life. And that was that. He pulled off because he know he was tripping for bringing his child to a war zone. If you got beef and problems with somebody, man, keep your kids away, man. Keep them at home. You can't be out here funking with these kids and then go to the grocery store like it's all good with your babies and shit and expect the next man to have mercy, because he not. I don't know what he shot that dude for. I don't know what he did to him for him to retaliate like that. I know it was a baby in the car. Thank God the baby wasn't hurt. But the baby finna grow up fucked up. The baby gonna have vengeance on his heart. Now what he gonna do when he get older? You see? It's an evolving cycle. It's an evolution. It keep going around and around. So even though this brother in jail for years, his brother dead, his child gotta grow up without his daddy. This other child gotta grow up without his daddy because he in the joint. But the dude he killed, he might have partners in the joint. See what I'm saying? And when he come home, if they don't deal with him in the joint, when he come home, people don't let that shit die. It could be 20 years from now, and I could still be upset about something you said to me in the 90s. If I see you, it's good. I still feel like you got something off, and I have to get my lick back. You know? And I ain't going to be thinking about no kids and no old folks at that time. I'm going to retaliate. You know? But those are the instincts that we need to break. So we got to stop doing foolish shit because he just shot this man in front of his child. Now they both gone. And the child finna grow up messed up. I don't know this brother that got killed, and I don't know the brother that did the kill, and I don't know the baby. But I'm going to pray for all three of them. St. Louis, we got to tighten up, man. It's your boy Lou from the Lou. Holler at me. Peace.